College football is more than a game. It's a spectacle. A feast for the senses. There is so much to see. So much to hear.
Noise.
Defensive calls.
The fans.
I'm focusing on the coaches.
The referees.
I hear the music.
The marching band is a huge part of the spectacle of a college football Saturday. It is a huge part of the fun of college football Saturday. Martel Van Zant has never heard the Cowboy marching band. He's not looking for your sympathy. But if you can imagine all these instruments of music, all these instruments of sheer sound being silent, then you have a sense of what game day is like for Martel Van Zant.
The Bedlam game was last played in Stillwater in 2004. Those were the sounds of that game to most of us. This is what it sounded like to Martel. Martel Van Zant was born deaf. Like many children born with disabilities, he was told he couldn't do certain things. Like play football. Maybe he didn't hear those statements since he is deaf. Or maybe he just didn't listen.
Every time I see him, it's just a joy to see that he's overcoming the odds. I'm starting on the defense for a Big 12 team.
Not only is he starting for a Big 12 team, he's excelling.
He's got such great football sense. You know, if you're trying to tell him something, you know, he's already on top of it. And, you know, you're just kind of bringing it back up to him, so he's good.
He said, do you want me to reroute on that, like 2x1?
Martel has an interpreter with him at all practices and games, except when he's actually between the lines. Then he gets the defensive signals through a series of gestures and football sign language. Many of the receivers he covers don't even realize he's deaf.
To them, I'm just an athlete. Sometimes they're talking trash out there, but I can't hear it.
That's actually probably good.
Yeah. You know, they're sitting there talking, and, you know, I could probably sign back to them, but it might confuse them a little too much.
His own teammates were a bit confused when he got to Stillwater 3 years ago. He was shy and quiet.
What I want you to do is change your alignment before the ball's kicked.
And there was obviously a communication gap.
Only time he really engaged in the conversation is when we talked to him.
Did you see what they wrote on the board?
Yeah.
Inside?
But now, man, you can't get Martel to shut up. We've been in locker room, you know, we'll take off our tape from our ankles and throw it at people. And you look up and Martel's throwing stuff at people.
Throwing stuff at him is not such a good idea, as a couple of Big 12 quarterbacks have learned the hard way this season.
Intercepted. Van Zant, and he takes it to the 20. And Van Zant, who is hearing impaired and has their own signal from the fans here to let him know when they applaud and they appreciate what he's doing.
We were all, you know, messing with him on the sideline, you know, because the way he was running with the ball, and he didn't, you know, take off like he wanted to score. And so I was just giving him a hard time on the sideline.
Our players do this to him all the time, meaning that everybody's clapping for him. That's their way of communicating to him that, or when he makes a good play, they'll do it to him themselves in practice, meaning good job. They're clapping, people are applauding your efforts.
Yeah, and then when I see him applause, you know, like after the interception and I got tackled, I just happened to look up and I saw everybody in the stands and my teammates cheering for me, so it made me feel good.
His interpreter, Ollie Lee, was there to convey all of the sentiments of the crowd and the team. After 3 years as Martel's interpreter, Ollie signs not just words, but emotions.
A lot of it is facial expression. You know, like if the coach is mad, then my interpreter will get an angry expression on his face. And the signs actually get bigger or more animated, so I know that they're angry and I need to play better.
He's actually become a great player and a great teammate.
Oh, you wouldn't win. So what, you never got an interception, never got a fumble recovery? Okay, all right.
Martel can handle himself on and off the field. We have known about him since his high school days at Tyler Lee. We weren't sure then if he could succeed at the next level. Since he has, It begs the question,
have you ever considered the possibility of playing at the next level in the NFL?
Yeah, I do think about that, and I think it is possible. You know, right now it's maybe 50-50. But personally, myself, I know I can play in the pros.
Even if he never played another down of football, he has already accomplished so much.
I get emails and letters all the time from other deaf children that he's their hero. They're not concerned about a Bobby Reed or a Bowman. Martel Van Zant's their hero.
It's a good catch over here a minute ago. Thank you.
He is an inspiration not only to the deaf community, but to his teammates and all of the OSU faithful. His success is a living, breathing message for anyone facing adversity.
Look at me, I'm here and I can do it.
And so can you.
He said in Buffalo 11, we went to May Day.
Default thought it was 26.
Thought it was 26. Oh, okay, all right.
This is John Rhadigan reporting.